So yeah, I thought I'd talk to you guys about upgrading, like leveling up to a bigger motorbike. So yeah, this bike is my first ever motorbike that I ever had. And yes, I was a little bit scared of riding a bike, so that's probably the main reason why I started out on a little 150cc. But man, I've done, look at that, 7,225 kilometers on this bike, and I bought it brand new. And I'm happy, man. It's been a great little first starter bike. It's getting me exactly where I want to go all the time. Amazing fuel consumption. I think I worked it out on this phone app that I have on my phone. It gets me about 2.8 liters per 100 kilometers, so with the 12 liter tank, it gets you over 400 kilometers on a tank, which is amazing when it comes to fuel economy. So yeah, let's talk about first going to your first bigger bike. Up to a while back, up to like a few days back actually, my mind was set on getting a Super Sport, a 600 Super Sport as my first big bike. But then, I think 2 days ago, me and Dad went and looked at the bikes, just to look at them really, not planning on buying them yet because I don't have money, I just went to look at them. And he doesn't like the Super Sports. He's not ever going to approve of me getting a Super Sport because they are really dangerous and fast and all that, which is true. But yeah, so I probably won't be getting a Super Sport yet, which now that I actually think of it, it is the smart idea, because going from a 150cc bike, yes, I do know the roads by now and I do know how to ride a motorbike. But going straight to a Super Sport is probably not the smartest idea, because to have all that power underneath you from going up from a bike that only has like 18 horsepower going to 118 horsepower is just, it's really stupid if you think of doing it. Unless you are a very confident rider and you know you'll be safe on the motorbike, then yeah, go for a 600 Super Sport. But it's not recommended. So we looked at other bikes, and bikes that are really looking nice would be the new CBR 500R. Man, that bike looks amazing. Plus, it's got like it's got the looks. It's so comfortable to sit on it, which is always a plus. Sitting on the CBR 500R, man, that felt good. And the bike is learner's approved because it only has, I think, 47 horsepower, so which is a great thing for someone who's still learning the roads. What's in the road here? Oh, I see. Yeah, so it's looking like a great bike for me to start on. Other bikes I was looking at would be the Yamaha FZ6R. Sounds like a really good bike. It's a bit heavy and all that, but that's only from what I've heard. I've never sat on it, so I wouldn't really know. But yeah, I really like it. There's another bike, the Ninja 650. Lennox Cliff's one also seems really good, but apparently it's got too much vibration, lower RPMs. It's got a lot of torque down low, but too much vibration. From what I've read, a lot of people say it's got a lot of vibration. So yeah, out of the bunch, I would say the CBR 500R looks to be the most promising. Yeah, yeah, that's a test of this bike's overtaking ability. It's not too bad, guys, for a 150cc. It's a tiny bike with a big heart. That's all I can say. So yeah, I'd really like it if you guys, whoever would be watching this video, just leave a comment and leave your thoughts on the three bikes that I've mentioned. It would be greatly appreciated to just like give me a bit of a mindset so that I can know a bit more about the bikes. And obviously I will probably go test riding these bikes once I start actually thinking of buying one, because at the moment I don't have money, so I'm just dreaming of one. So I will go test ride them, and I'll most likely make a video while I do this. But for now, yeah, those are the bikes I really like and I'd really like to get. So yeah, leave a comment on what you guys think of these three bikes that I've mentioned. But yeah, for now, I'll finish my cruise to Chillingham, and I'll make a video again for you guys later. See you guys.